Hi everyone, and welcome to my new video. In this video, I'm gonna talk about custom pages and commanding. Yesterday, the custom pages preview was announced on the Power Apps blog. Custom pages is something that is really cool because it combines two worlds, the model-driven world and the canvas world. And what Microsoft is trying to achieve is to have one Power App instead of the different types that we have now. So no model-driven canvas choice anymore, just create your app. And if you create a custom page, it's a canvas kind of experience. And you can, for instance, embed that inside of your app. So you can have the left side navigation from a model-driven app and have on the right side a custom page, which gives you all the different connectors that you have within canvas apps. And you can combine those together with your model-driven apps. So it's going to be a converged experience. That's what Microsoft calls it. Next to that, we also have the commanding preview. And that's what actually got released today. And that's now in public preview. And the commanding preview makes it possible for you to create extra buttons inside of your apps. So when you have a model-driven app, you might have seen that already, that you have at the top all kinds of buttons like new, delete, and all those kinds of experiences that you have. The commanding preview makes it possible for you to add your own buttons there. And what can those buttons do? You can, for instance, have a PowerFX formula in there. And the PowerFX formula gives you all the abilities, or a lot of the abilities, that you also have within Canvas apps. So you can navigate, you can do all kinds of stuff with the data that you have within your app. And if you combine that, for instance, with the custom pages preview, that's going to be really cool. And that's something I'm going to show you today. So we're going to use custom pages within our new app experience. We're going to create a really simple app there. And then I'm going to include that in the app. And I'm going to create a command. And I'm going to use JavaScript in that command instead of the PowerFX formulas. But you can also use JavaScript, and I'm going to use that to open the custom page on the sidebar. So that's something I'm going to show you today. So without further ado, let's dive in. Okay, here we are in a solution I just prepared. There's a custom pages solution, and there's nothing in there. So let's start by creating an app, and we're going to choose the model-driven app here, and make sure to select the modern app designer. It's still in preview. Let's select create and then add a name for that. We're going to call this custom pages and command. When we hit create, it's going to create the app here. It's still empty right now, but we are going to change that and add a table based view and form in here. There's also some other types. You can, for instance, select a dashboard if you want to see some nice graphs here. And you can select a custom page. And that's still in preview, of course, because that has been announced yesterday. Let's select table-based view and form and select next. Now I'm going to add the contact table in here. I'm going to leave the show in navigation on because I want to have the link contact on the left side. So let's hit add. And it's gonna load right now. And you can see a preview here of my model-driven app with the left side navigation where contacts is in. And you can also see that there's group one. And I don't think, I really don't like the fact that it's called group one. So you can change to the navigation here. Go to the group one part and then rename that. And in this case, I'm just going to call it general. And when you look at the preview, you can see that general is in here instead of group one. And I think that's a lot better. When I save this and I'll publish this one, I can actually play the app and then I can show you around how the app looks. So let's hit play, and then you can see here that we have the contacts part here. We have some contacts in here and we have some buttons here at the top. But now let's add another page and let's call that a custom one. And let's hit next. And you can choose here to start with a new page or an existing one. In this case, we are going to use a new one. So let's call this custom page demo. And let's select add. And when you do that, you end up in the canvas designer and you can start creating your own canvas app here. For now, we are going to use some really simple scenario. So I'm just going to drag a button on top of this canvas app and I'm going to change this to an alert, for instance. And I can change this to advanced and go to the on select one. And let's maybe do a notify and add some text here. Error. This is an error. And then we need a notification type. So let's leave that as an error. And when I save this, let's call it a custom page demo, of course, and save it. Then it will get saved into my solution. I can go back. I can hit the publish button, publish this version. And that's when we have published the custom page. When we hit preview, we can actually see what it does. It's really simple. It just has a button in here and it gives me an error at the top with a notify formula. Let's go back to the designer. And we now see that the page is not found. Page need to be included in model-driven pages list and then republished. I haven't yet added that in here. It goes automatically, but I need to republish it. And I don't see the preview yet. I hope it's opening up now. Sometimes takes a while before that error disappears. So please be aware of that, but I haven't seen it yet. Come on, open it up. Ah, here it is. Now it also shows in preview. So when I hit play, I can see the actual app and I can, oh, it's not yet there. Okay, here we are. And I can see the app here and select alert. I can get the error at the top. So that all works really, really nice. But sometimes, and that's also because it's a preview, you will still see some error messages or something, but nothing really big so far that I've seen. So now we have the app. And in here, we of course have the context part and the custom page in here. That's it for the custom pages part. But sometimes when you are working with a model-driven app, you want some extra buttons in here. So there are a bunch of buttons that are available here. They are called commands that you have here. For instance, new. And when you hit new, you get a form where you can create a new contact, for instance. But all those buttons are provided by Microsoft. And sometimes you also want to add your own. Before we had to go to certain community build options, for instance, the Ribbon Workbench, that is still a great option, by the way. But now we have commanding. And how do you use that? When you are in the app designer, you see app, contact, and the custom page in here. But for the contact, because that's a table, we can have command bars for that. And when you hit the ellipses on the side and you hit edit command bar, it will open up a new window and you will see edit command bar. And there's multiple options here. There's the main grid. And the main grid is when you open up your table and it looks like this. So you can see multiple different contacts in here, multiple records. And you can see the buttons here at the top. So So if you want to change this view of the command bar, you need to have the main grid part. The main form is when you want to change the buttons. When you hit, for instance, new, there's some other options here. And maybe you want to add another one and do some action in there. Then you have the subgrid view. That's when, for instance, you have the account table, and there's a relation between contacts and accounts. And every account can have multiple contacts, for instance. So when you have the contact subgrid in your account form, then you can also add those commands and edit them. And then lastly, the associated view, and that's the part which you will see in the form when you have multiple tabs and you want to also edit those commands in there. For now, we are just going to use the main grid, and I'm going to select edit. So we're going to edit that part. And it loads pretty fast, actually. It looks a bit like the canvas designer. And we see a lot of buttons here. There's a lot of buttons here because sometimes there's multiple new buttons, but that's because those can have different options in there. But there's also activate, deactivate, for instance. And when we go look at the main grid, we don't see those in here. We only see those when we open up the contacts, for instance. Then you see deactivate in here. And when I have deactivated a contact, the activate button will show up. So they're also context aware. Now, if I want to add a new command, let's do that. At the left side, you can see the commands. You can hit new command, and then you will see a button where you have new command in there. You can edit the label. So let's say open custom page. And what I can do here is also select an icon. So I can just select a drop down here and scroll down a little bit. And let's use, for instance, the article link. You have tooltip title, tooltip description, and accessibility text, which are really handy if you have a production scenario. But for this test, I am gonna skip this for now. You have the order number to make sure that your button is actually at the first one in the row, or maybe the second one. You can actually use that to make sure a button appears at some point. The action part is actually the most important part, because you have two options there. You have the run formula option, and you can open the formula bar there, and that's where you can use power effects. So you can use navigate, for instance, and navigate to a different screen in there. So those options, that's what you have there. You can also use other formulas in there, and that's really cool. You can also use other data sources, for instance, if you want to do that, etc. The other option that you have, and that's the one we're going to use today in this demo, is the run JavaScript option. So when you hit the run JavaScript action, you can select a library. There are some libraries in here, but my library isn't in there yet because I haven't created that in the Dataverse environment. So when I hit add library, I can see all kinds of JavaScript libraries that are available in this environment. I can add a new one, but in this case, I'm going to do it a little bit different. So I'm going to hit cancel here. I'm going to go back to my environment. So let's hit back. Oh, it's not in here yet. So let's open the environment here. Oh, hold on. There we go. Let's go to solutions and to the custom pages solution. And here we can actually see that we have a sitemap, model-driven app, a page, and a component library. The component library is actually what we just created when we started with the commanding. The page is what we created with a custom page. The model-driven app and the sitemap appeared when we created the model-driven app. And now in here, I also want a JavaScript file. The JavaScript file is currently on my local machine. I have that here, but I need to change some things. This is actually a sample script I got from Microsoft, and I will include it in the comments below when I post this video. And in here, we actually need to add the name of the page that we want to open. And we can also change the title of the dialogue that we are gonna show at the site. So let's open this up a little bit and see how our page is actually called. The first part I already got right because I used the custom page demo as a name for my page. But the last part is 9AAC8. That's something that was generated just now. I need to save it again. And that's actually my JavaScript that I need to use. Now let's add this to our environment. Select new, more, and select web resource because that's what we need for JavaScript file. In here, I'm gonna use the test site. That's the name I chose for my file. I'm gonna select JavaScript and I'm gonna upload the file. Save it. And now it's added to our environment. And let's hit publish so that it's also published. So far, that's the part what we need for the JavaScript. Let's go back to the commanding. And we of course need to add the library now to this command. Let's select the test and search for that. We have to wait a little bit because the search is taking some time. And then we can just select that and click add. Now we have the library in there. I need to add a function, and the function is something I also have in here because it's a function called site dialog. I just copy paste that and add that to the command at the sidebar. So here we have site dialog. It didn't take any parameters, so we don't need to add that. But for now, our command is actually ready. So let's click save and publish. And now we can go back to our app. If it's done with the publishing, it probably needs a couple of refreshes because it takes a little while before the button actually appears. So let's go back to contacts. You can see that it's not there. So let's refresh. And here it is. So the open custom page is now in here. I can open it up and then I can see my page in here. I can hit alert. Can also see that the error is in there. I can do all kinds of things. And the cool thing is that you're already authenticated in here. So the user can also fill in a form maybe and start up a Power Automate workflow or do some other stuff that's really cool for this scenario. So there's tons of possibilities here. And I think that a lot of people will love to use this. One thing I want to show you as well is that you can do a lot with the JavaScript part. I actually used the custom page on the site and I used the 100% width, but you can also, for instance, change this to 50, or 50 is a little bit small, but let's call it 450, and then change the unit to px, so that's pixels. And then when we go back to the web resource, we can upload it again. Let's choose a file, save it, and publish it again. And now the new JavaScript one is in here. And when we refresh this, it opens the custom page in a much smaller size. And that's something that you have to be aware of as well, because when you open it to the site this small, you really want to make sure that you have a responsive app, for instance, because if we had, for instance, some kind of gallery in here, which was really wide, then it wouldn't show in here. So make sure that you be aware of that, because otherwise you will not have the greatest experience in here. With that, we are at the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and make sure to check this out, because those features, custom pages and commanding, are really cool, and they are now in public preview. So whatever you do, if you want to learn something new, make sure to check these previews out. They are really cool to work with, and I'm sure that you can create tons of scenarios that are interesting for customers. So this is the end of my video. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you at the next video.